That's a good thing because I'm not in mania. Like I'm normal. I'm fine, and you know, it's not noticeable. I'm regular, but yes, I don't know how the hell, 'cause I don't search for people on TikTok. Like I don't know how. I guess they said it's the algorithm. I'm old, so I don't know about social media, and it's sad because I asked my friends, like, you know, I'm still learning Instagram. You know, I learned how to do a story last year. You know, so, you know, I'm not tech savvy. I am, but to a certain extent, I don't let it run my life or whatever. But, you know, it's different now. But, you know, I don't understand, man, how much you know that you are appreciated. I don't think you can understand. I never met you before. I'm on the other side of the world. I'm in a different state in a small town. And I am rooting for you, man. Listen here. The freaking Michael Jackson. I like Michael Jackson. I did a tribute to him. And the fact that you have the moonwalking board, like,
Oh, yeah.
I said, okay, I've been on this earth for 29 years. I never seen nobody in my year of dancing have the fucking board. Like, you have the board. Only person that has that shit is Michael Jackson. Only because I seen the making of the video. You are the only human being that took it that far. I think that shit is fucking bad. Like I'm minding my business. Minding my business, eating my breakfast, and I seen you do that shit. I was like, what the fuck? I'm like, what, yo, he's about that life. He is dedicated. Like, if I was an artist and I didn't do that shit out. I like, oh, yo, you bad about it. Like, he did not come. And to do it on TikTok, I was like, nah, he didn't come to play. If I was an artist, I'd be like, yo, this kid. You have the board. Like, the only person that did that shit was Michael Jackson. I never see how you that you are amazing. I don't even call people. I speak when I only speak to people that's worth speaking to. You know, silence is golden, but whew, boy, your mother did a phenomenal job with you.
And I will definitely pass that along to her. Like I said earlier, you know, she definitely extends her appreciation. I'll be sure and tell her again. And you know, and I just want to say, you know, thank you. Also, thank you so much for the Gatorades. Like, I was like, oh, sweet, they're here. And then, because I took a bottle with me to work. And it definitely helped. I'm like, yo, because it was like busy where I was working. So, thank you for sending the Gatorade, and just thank you for, you know, supporting me and just everything, honestly.
No,
I can't really thank you.
I like supporting people that actually do the work. I had a dancer friend, and you know, I show appreciation, and that's something that I love to do. Whether it's buying them food or whatever, because it just makes my soul happy to see you guys do y'all thing. And I am so happy. I from that realm, and I accept that my mother sees it also, that I'm from that time, and it's okay. You know, people are born and we're human beings, you know, different beings, different entities. Everyone is intricate, everyone is unique. You know, we got some people that's ahead of their time. You got some people You know, we all are star seeds. You know, we all are, you know, born at, you know, different times, you know, in different attributes. But man, let me show you how the universe works. I finally met you, and you know, the universe was doing the right thing, and you know, like I said, I see my childhood, man. Listen. Yeah, you make me want to bring out my gold dancing stick. I'm going to actually look for it. I'm going to go upstairs and see if my father still got his guitar and stuff like that. He got his acoustic. I just went upstairs, but I'm going to look for his electric, because God damn it, man. You just make me. I was on YouTube minding my business, doing my 70 songs, you know, in my own world. As usual in the 70s, but to see a kid, a beautiful human being that I can share that experience with, it's everything. I don't feel like an outcast. I don't feel alienated. You know, I don't feel misunderstood. I know that when I dance with you, it makes me so happy. And it's a grateful and an honorable experience, man, because like I said, I don't know you, never met you before or whatever, but it's just out of respect that you love, man.
Oh my gosh, I truly, I get, you know, I get speechless, so I but no, seriously, thank you. I really can't thank you enough just for saying that. And honestly, this Here's what I think. You know, this whole thing was like pre-planned by the universe. You know, everything always has purpose to it.
Of course.
And it's like this makes sense. You know, it makes sense. It makes sense to me. It makes sense to you, because it's like you just can't really question it. You know. It's
yeah.
Like,
wow, exactly. I was.
You know? Yeah. So.
Yeah, I was thinking that in the shower also. I was like, God damn. And, you know, I got more experience with life, I got more understanding. I read a lot. So ever since I started reading, I understand that, you know, like I told my therapist before my year started, I know that it's new people I'm meeting, new blessings, all new everything, like I said on my Instagram. And, you know, you never know who you're going to meet. You're never going to know, because it's the universe. It's a mysterious thing. And I take that, you know, from the creator. And I told him thank you, you know, when I was taking my shower this morning before I started my day, that, yo, you doing right by me. You know, thank you once again. You know, I always thank the creator before each year start. You know, new blessings, new people, and you know what you got planned out. You know, I'm on your time. You know, but yeah, you know, someone in this world love you and appreciate you more than you could ever know. And I hope you feel that in your soul, because I really, really, really love music from that time. I love Heatwave so much. You know, I was trying to find. Around that time, I was on Facebook. I was trying to find the band members, and some past my father told me. But, you know, I was fortunate to see the people that you listen to live. A lot of the groups you listen to, the Whispers, the Intruders, the OJs, and to be around them and to be around the people. In my teenage years, I gotta find the pictures also. My father has it in his emails, because we go to their concerts or whatever. So, you know, everybody that you listen to, I was fortunate to see. Like, I was a teenager, you know, and I was, you know, sneaking out the house, getting him out, telling him, let's go.
Yeah.
You know, that's my childhood. And I tell some of the group members on YouTube, I love them so much. Let me go through my phone. Let me see. Yeah, the Whispers. My father talks to members from the Whispers, still to this day, you know. I love them so much. And, like I said, a lot of the groups you listen to, my father, is friends with. So, you know, I tell them I love them so much. I tell them I love them, and I let them know that they love, because they're taking their time and energy to give us good music. And I show them that I continuously show them that I love them, and I will continuously show them that I love them while I'm here, you know, and let them know that they're loved, and, you know, I love them so much. But, you know, I had some very beautiful years, you know, like I said on my channel, that to see the people and to travel and to do it safely and smoothly, and to tell them that I love them is everything, you know. Absolutely. So I'm very fortunate to tell them while I'm here that I love them, because, you know, these people are taking the time out to, you know, give us something good rather than the shit we listen to now. I'm on that other side. I'm not on that side. I'm on this side. We on this side. Me and you, we on this side. We not on that side. So being I'm on this side, I tell them I love them. And I'm going to continuously tell them I love them. You know, ever since COVID happened, I can't travel the way I want. You know, but I message them and I tell them I love them.
Yeah.
You know, so, you know, ever since COVID happened, it has been a blessing in disguise. I learned a lot about myself, and, you know, I learned that, you know, tomorrow is not promised. And if I did pass during the pandemic, I said what I said, I did what I did, and I don't have no regrets, you know.
Yeah.
I was open, you know. And I let them know that they was loved. So what I'm going to do, I can't, you know, control, you know, what the creator plan or plan for me. That's not in my control. But one thing I can do is show appreciation while I'm here, you know, and I don't regret it. I don't regret telling people that I love them.
Yeah, that's a beautiful thing right there. There's a lot of people, they... You know, a lot of people, they don't ever really want to take the time to just, like, open up and tell those people that they love, hey, you know, I love you so much and I appreciate you, you know, so that...
You know, I've been that way since I was a child, a kid. That's who I am. I don't like to talk a lot. I told you, you know, when I first started speaking to you verbally, that I'm not big on talking. Like, I don't like to communicate. That's something that I struggle with since a kid, yeah. And I struggle with now, and it's okay. I accept that. But, you know, if I tell you I love you, if I communicate with you, if I tell you how I feel, you know, honor that, you know, cause I don't like to talk, you know? Yeah. But other than that, you know, I just had to, cause this, how my mother said, you always texting. All you kids want to do is type. Y'all don't want to talk on the phone no more. That's not communicating. Like, my father's like, all y'all do is texting. Y'all don't call. And that's not, like, that's what my mother thought. That's not communication. Talking and texting is not communication. That's not real. So, you know, I had to definitely call you so you could, you know, vocally hear my voice, you know, authentically. Yeah, I save your videos to my phone, which is weird because it makes me so happy seeing it. Like, I feel alive. I feel like my being, like, I feel like Sarah, like, I feel like the real me, like, looking at the real me, the 5-year-old me, that joy. I feel like myself watching your videos. When I say I feel like myself, I feel the authenticity right from your videos. Like, I feel, it's like a transferable thing. Like, I feel my childhood. So, when I see your videos, I'm connecting with that 5-year-old girl, and this is what I'm trying to tell you. This is why I'm so happy when I see your videos.
Oh man, this is just deep. In a good way.
Yeah, like my father, he works really hard, so you know, I don't get a chance to speak to him like how we usually when we was younger, you know, and you know, hopefully when his time slows down, I can show him or probably play it in my car when we driving or he's driving me somewhere, definitely, because he's always, you know, working. But yeah, he would love you. He would, I think that you are my father's child. He would love you, like literally. I think that you came from him, and you're my long lost brother. I'm convinced. He said he had kids from other women, and it's a joke, but you know he would love you. If you was his son, you know, I have a brother, but he's not. You know, he's National Guard. And he does his own thing. He's not musically inclined like we are and stuff like that. We're two different beings. Like, people that know me and my brother, you wouldn't even think that was my brother. But if you was my if you was my biological brother, they would know that you're my father's son. Like, people would know, his friends that he grew up in school and his musician friends would definitely know that that was his son. Because I swear to God, I don't know how this happened, but you were supposed to be my brother. And this is what I'm trying to tell people. So when I show him your videos, I'm going to say, did you have a son? Is this my brother? And I will show him your videos. Like, is this something you're not telling me? Because this is insane. I don't know why we are not related, because your whole, how can I put this? Your whole aura, your whole essence is definitely something that my father would create, literally. Because I said, oh, my father would have a good time with you. But, you know, if I was fortunate to have a kid, you know, I would want my father to raise him, and then it would come out to be turned out like you. Like, if I had a kid and he raised him, it would be you. I'm sorry. That's the only way I can say it. Because you, my father, all he gonna do, because I know him, all he gonna do is mold him into something like you. That's all he gonna do. That's all he gonna do. And he already told me that. I'm like, I don't have kids yet. Oh, we're going to give him James Brown. Oh, they're going to have an instrument. They're going to have a guitar. We're going to have them. He already planned that out.
I believe it. I mean, the funny thing is like, there's literally a bass guitar up in here in my studio, a regular guitar, a keyboard. I had a drum set up in here, but it was old and all that stuff. And you know, I quit playing. I just decided to get rid of it. But, like, yeah, we got, like, you know, the djembe drums and stuff, and like practice pads, tambourines and shit. Excuse me, but
yeah, no, that's upstairs. Everything you just said is literally upstairs. I went upstairs, and I don't know, because I'm actually recording this conversation, because it's, I just love, good. Yeah, I really need to channel that 5-year-old girl. So I'm just taking it in confirmation. Yeah. From the universe, so yeah. So out everything.
Yeah, do everything you need to do to, like, cause like I said before, this is like so divine. Like this whole conversation with, you know, I honestly think, gosh, it just makes you think how complex, you know, God is and just how the universe works, because it's like all of this was pre-planned. You know, pre-planned, like this conversation right here, the realization, the all of it.
Yeah.
Just all of it. So
Yeah, everything that you named is upstairs. I was actually, he probably gonna listen because he watched my YouTube channel. He low-key, I know he watched my channel and I don't care. Yeah, I went upstairs in your music room looking for your black guitar. I don't care. I don't care. I don't care. You know, yeah, definitely, you know, all he gonna do, if I had a son, if I'm blessed or fortunate to have a kid, that all he gonna do is turn it, all he's gonna do is be you. That's it. It's gonna be you. It is gonna be you. That's all he's, I'm telling you, this is what he does. You know, and you know, I want to wear my fro more. I was making my lunch, and I was like, damn, you make me want to bring out my fro wigs. You make me want to break out. You make me want to pluck out my fucking hair and change. You, like, I didn't even want to be, like, wear pink. Like, I was like, damn, this dude is going to make me go on Poshmark and just buy 70s elephant shirts and go. Like, I was like, damn, I was gonna inbox you. You know, you make me want to buy all my gold clothes from the 70s. My mother was like, why do you buy elephant sleeve shirts? Like, you make me want to go there. I just might go there. I am gonna go there. I don't care, because you understand the message.
Yeah, absolutely. Let me tell you this. Please do that, because, like, there's literally a store down the street from my house, like a vintage store. It's called Robertful Vintage. Mm-hmm. You go in there, they got, like, the vibes in there are, like, literally just 60s, 70s, 80s, all that
the
stuff.
The store you went to on TikTok, the store you did on TikTok? That store?
Yeah.
I see. Oh yeah, man, I want to show my father that. I'm not speaking to him right now because I got a new number. But yeah, I definitely want to show him that store.
Yeah, absolutely. Cause I get all my stuff out of there, and like because I need to go back in there anyway and find some more stuff. But I told my mom recently. I was like, I really don't care what people think, because I honestly want to start I want to walk around and like wear bell bottoms and
you know what I want to say also to you, and I'm glad we're having this conversation, and I'm going to be completely honest with you. I am glad you do not care what people think. Listen, this is the headline. I am glad you do not give a damn what someone thinks about you. Because if you did, I wouldn't like you. You would be someone else. I wouldn't even know who you are. I wouldn't even know your essence. I wouldn't know you if you said, oh, I want to, you know, wear a baseball cap, dress modern, and do this. No, you are living in your truth, and listen here. The fact that you do not give a damn, I think that shit is beautiful. That shit is so effing beautiful. The fact that you don't care.
I wouldn't even
have love for you if you listen to people. Because if you listen to people, you wouldn't be yourself.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Yeah, no, absolutely. I mean,
You know what's so crazy? You have a million human beings on this planet, right? You got people that's listening to other people. Me and you, what time is it? It is like 11:21. You got people in this here that you know, I know you know. You got people here that listen to other people and they're not themselves. I was that person. In my time on earth, I was her. I don't care no more. My friends know I don't care, and they love that.
Yeah.
I'm happy. I'm so happy. And it's not an easy thing. Because you could have easily said F it. You could have easily said F it and not did those videos. I wouldn't even know who you was. I would have just missed you. I would have just walked past you. And we would have never even known each other if you would have listened.
Yep.
And then I could have died. We both, our time, you know, passed. I'm not putting that, our time would pass and we would not even met each other.
Probably,
you know, just the one in a million thing. You know, if you listen, I wouldn't even know you.
Yeah, you don't flip when I tell you this. So, like, it was my mother's birthday. My mother's birthday is November 1st. So, we took her out to one of her, like, her favorite Mexican restaurant. And I was like, you know what? We was all getting ready to leave. I'm like, Mom, I'll be right back. Because I, like, had, like, you know, just, like, casual, well, it wasn't necessarily casual, but it was like a, you know, dress shirt and all that stuff. I was like, nah, I gotta switch this up a little bit. So I was like, hey, I'll be out in just a minute. So I went up in my room, I changed, and I was like, let me put this black turtleneck on, these black dress pants, my loafers, black socks, my black fedora, and then on top of that, I have this, it's like a, it's like a purple, I think I had it on one of my TikTok, but it's like a purple, it's like a cloak or something, not necessarily like a cloak, but it's like a kind of like a robe or something like mm-hmm. that, and has like these gold, like gold stripes and all that stuff. I had that on, Lord have mercy, I tell you, I put that thing on, and I was like, I'm not trying to brag, because I really hate bragging, but at the same time, like,
pop your shit. No, no, he's like, go ahead.
So, yeah, I had that on. I hooked my phone up to, like, the Bluetooth speaker in the living room, and I was like, hey, is everybody ready? And they're like, yeah, what are you doing? I put on, okay, you remember the movie, Let's Do It Again?
Mm-hmm.
I put on the soundtrack called Big Mac when John Amos walks through the room. You know, that's mm-hmm. that dun 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 dun. I had that on. I literally timed it when I walked through the door that goes to my room, and they all looked at me. They're like, "Boy," because like I was feeling it. I'm like, I want to do this. I don't care. I will go to the mall on a busy Saturday night mm-hmm. dressed up like I'm somebody from the 70s, you know. I will do that, like, in a heartbeat.
Oh,
in a
man.
Heartbeat. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, wow. Yeah, my father would definitely he would love you. Oh my God.
I love your father already. I'm just gonna put it right there. I love your father already.
Yeah, he was born in 69, so you know yeah. You know what type of man he was, and, you know, I'm fortunate to have one that was born in 69, because, you know, I had, that shit was flooded in my house. Woo, boy, I had a good childhood. Whoa, boy, God, oh, man, I had a good childhood, and,
you know,
what molded me as a kid was music from the 60s and 70s. And until I got to my teens, it was 80s and 90s. And then teens was the 2000s. But if that was what I had when I was a kid, that's my foundation. That's my soil. That's my dirt. That's my goal. That's my plot. That is my... that's my being. So when I go to those shows and I go to those concerts, I'm running to my childhood. And I was fortunate to tell them, thank you for giving me the best childhood. Because, you know, your time here, like I said, is limited. You always want to, you know, I have it in my mind, you know, I have a good therapist. Every year I try to have a good year. I do things to make me have a good year, whether it's giving back, kind acts, helping out strangers, those little things. I never see them again. Don't question it. I don't care. I do those things because it makes me happy. It makes my soul happy. I thought this morning I found what makes my soul happy, you know. So when I did it, that's nothing. I've been doing that since I was a kid. So, you know, I don't know you. I don't know a lot of people, and I don't care. That's who I, that's me. That's my inner child. That's that five-year-old girl. So when I get to channel her and I get to bring her out, that's when I'm the happiest.
Right.
You know, so, yeah, you know, he gave me a good foundation, and he know that I thank him for that. And it mean a lot to me. You know, it just means a lot. It means a lot because he loved me. You know, he didn't have to. You know, he didn't have to, you know. He didn't have to.
Hey, but you know what? He did, though.
He didn't have to. Like I told my grandfather, you know, y'all didn't have to love us. You know, this things could have went different. It could have went the completely opposite of what we had when we would grow up. But, you know, I'm fortunate to him to give me the music you listen to. I'm so fortunate in this time to have that understanding of what real love is and what healthy love is and what healthy love, healthy music could be, and to grow up on that. A lot of people didn't get that chance. It's very rare. And when I see your mother, I see your mother. And when I see your mother, I said, thank you. God damn it, thank you. She did her thing with you. She did a good job with you. You know, she did her thing, man. She could have easily had you listen to what people listen to today. She could have easily had you listen to hip-hop and gangster music and all these things. But your mother enriched you. Your mother took her time with you. She enriched you. She gave you a good foundation. And that's what I seen when I seen your mother. And I seen your mother, I was clapping. I was on my iPhone clapping. I was like, yes, thank you, Mom. You know, a little small thing to her is a big thing to me. And she did a good job with you.
I appreciate you saying that so much. Thank you so much.
You know, she did a good job with you. But definitely, we are going through this COVID, you know, I guess they say, quote unquote, the powers that be or whatever. It's, you know, the universe is taking its cleanse, and I love her. And how my grandmother said, you know, it's a frightening feeling. I had a very empowering grandmother, a very good grandmother. And she told me, you know, I was talking to one of my guy friends a couple of years ago, don't fear nature. And, you know, the earth is doing its cleanse, and I pray every morning. I pray before I go to bed. I pray in the afternoon. You know, I pray a lot, and my therapists and my friends know that I'm praying for everyone. I'm praying for the world because we're going through uncertain times. You know, I'm waiting for when that transit slows down. You know, when that transit, you know, because we don't know what's going on underground. We don't know what's going on in the sky. Once that transit calms and slows down, you know, I want to go back to traveling. I definitely want to meet you. And I want to meet my subscribers. And like I said, you don't have to pay for dinner. You don't have to pay for nothing. It's just the fact that I get to meet a beautiful soul like you, and that's what means the most to me. And my friends know that's I appreciate you, and I continuously tell my friends that I love them and I appreciate them.
We love and appreciate you too. You hear me?
Yeah, I love you.
We
Yeah,
love and appreciate you too.
I said, pick out the cookies, pick out the cookies. And then when I clicked the link, I clicked the link because I couldn't see it. I seen heart cookies. I said, oh, okay, this is what he wants. I said, this is what he wants—a heart cookies. Because it could have been, it could have been anything. Because I didn't care. I didn't care about the price. I said, you pick what you like. And I just thought about doing that because I don't know. It was just a random thought. It's a welcome. It's like a hi. It's like a neighbor when you move in the neighborhood and the neighbors give you cookies.
Yeah, you're
It
so
was an
sweet.
appreciation because I would send flowers, but I'm so broke right now. Like literally broke right now. Well, I'm not broke, but I just don't want to leave the house. Like I'm so scared to leave the house.
Oh no, I get that.
I stay in the, I stay in, in my area. I'm not, I can go out, but, I just go out when it's important, so definitely, I wanted to surprise you. I want to send you some roses. I'm gonna say it anyway. I'm gonna send you some roses because I gotta give you your roses. I'm gonna give you I'm gonna send you some roses. I used to work at a flower shop, so I was always sending them. But when I was doing e-com, I was sending roses, and the lady didn't pay for them, and I didn't care. She had a wedding. I sent her like two bouquets, and she wanted her refund. I didn't care. People gonna be people. I can't stop people from being people. But I'm
Yeah.
definitely gonna give you your roses, cause and write. And write a heartfelt letter, to you, and maybe you want to frame it or whatever, but yeah,
I will do that. Don't like, I'm serious. I will do that. I will try. I treasure stuff like that.
yeah, I'm definitely gonna give you your roses. I thought of that this morning. Gonna give you your roses and. Boy, you did heat wave. When I seen heat wave, I said that is a universal newfound respect that I have for you. That is a that's like me taking my heart, like slicing my chest and pulling my heart out bloody and giving it to you because if you knew the type of childhood I have, you would understand why I would give you like my heart. I snatch my heart out my chest, my bloody heart, and give it to you. Cause, boy, I love them so much. Like I was like, how was I? I was 18 years old, 18, 19, looking for them. Like, are the group members alive? Where are the concerts? Where are the ceremonies? And I was so young, and my father know I was so dedicated to see. I didn't care. I don't care how young I was, because I would tell them that I love them, just to
Yeah.
tell them that I love them. So I was really young, because I had them on my Facebook page and stuff like that. Like those are my guys. Heat Wave is my guys. Those are my favorite men. I love them. The OJs. The Whispers. What is it? I love them. Magic Mendez. I love them so much, and I continuously tell them I love them so much.
Yep, absolutely. And you know what? Even the excuse me. Even you know the even those who have passed on. You know,
I
they
know.
hear you. You
I
know,
know. I
yeah.
know. I know that at I knew that at 18 and 19 when I found out they passed, but I still, honored them. And I remember and I'm sharing parts of you that I don't share with no one else. I remember I was in my room And I was searching for them, and I was like, oh man, if you guys were still here, you don't know how much you love. And I remember saying that and thinking that and looking at their photo, like, you got this girl here, and she's looking for you, and she loves you so much. And thank you for giving us great music and stuff like that. But, you know, this, I like the Jones Girls also, and some of the members died also. There's a lot of people that died, but one thing that I learned while they tour, they replace other people, you know, and stuff like that. So it doesn't mean, okay, so some of the members died, but that doesn't mean that they didn't replace them. And that's one thing my father showed me. So for, you know, about 10 years, I get to see the replacements. And I, you know, Heatwave and those groups, they still go. And they have the youth doing it. And I seen the young girls covering, you know, the people that I listen to. And I'm so happy. I'm so happy, you know. And, you know, I went on this cruise that a good friend of mine used to take me, Diana. And they would play all the oldies, and we would be on the water for like 2 hours. And to be that 5-year-old girl on the cruise, to be my, there's a side of me that people know, but very few see and understand where I'm coming from. So to be on that cruise, that summertime cruise where they play the music that we love, that me and you love. I am not myself. I am a different being. I am happy. I am that 5-year-old girl. I'm that happy girl. I'm my identity. Like, that entity is there on that cruise, and I'm happy. My father, when we go, I have the videos on my YouTube. When he goes, he knows what he raised, and he sees what he raised and stuff like that. So he gets to see me in my essence, and you know, Diana gets to see me. My mother gets to see me. You know, strangers get to see me. And they understand that I am myself. This is who I am. I get to listen to music from the 70s and the 80s and, you know, the 60s. It goes to 60s, 70s, and 80s on that cruise. And to be trapped on the water and to dance and, you know, to be around strangers that don't even know you, and it's all love. It's where I want to be. I wish I could. How my mother said, life isn't a party. But to me, I tried to create that. So that's why I love dancing with you, and I'm happy I get to dance with you, because I am in my essence. And, you know, when you see me dance, just know that that's not me. That's that 5-year-old girl that was happy and free. And that's not me. That's the 5-year-old girl. That's her. She's not dead.
No. But, you know, anytime you know, you want to do, like, any kind of dance collabs, you know, I'm totally down. And not even just, like, you know, on TikTok. Like, even, like, when we actually do, like meeting all that stuff, you get to, you know, meet my family and all that stuff. Like, we all definitely gotta, like, just go somewhere and just, like, dance.
Oh, absolutely. I was thinking about that this afternoon, and I don't want to bug you. I don't want to be annoying. You know, that's a dream to me. That's a literally, that's a dream to me. So, yeah, I didn't write that in my book yet. You know, I definitely, my deal was to do dinner, because I'm just happy with that. I just want to tell you that I love you, you know, physically and to meet you. But, you know, that's the icing on the cake. You know, like I said, I wouldn't even know how to act if I was dancing with you. I'd probably explode into the thin air, because you ignite something in me. Like a match. All I'm going to do is explode. Like, all you're going to do is, because your spirit, that freaking, the freaking, the freaking leader of Heatwave, all the James Brown, all that shit is gonna combust with minds, and we gonna channel some shit.
Yeah.
That shit is gonna be magical. Literally, all it is gonna be magical. It's gonna be divine.
Absolutely, I'm gonna find because we have a lot of places here in Indianapolis where there's dance parties and all that stuff. I'm gonna find something.
Oh man, even I was thinking, I don't want to be a pushover, I don't want to be bossy, but I usually fly people out to, I pay for their food, their flights and stuff to dance with me from around the world. So, my friends know that they don't ever have to pay for anything because the only thing I'm asking for is your time. So, being that you're taking the time out of your life, I confiscate, for, taking care of you, because you don't have to, take the time out of your life because it's your time. I'm asking for your time. Even when I do with my fathers or my friends, if I say, yo, we gonna get up. Y'all want to go out to eat? It's Friday. Where we going? I got it. I got the bill. So, they don't have to worry about it because I want to spend time with them. They could be doing a million things, definitely, my mind is literally gone. The thought of you saying that you would like to dance with me, I wouldn't even be happy if I was dancing with Usher. I see you higher than them. I don't even like some of these dances, and my mother knows I don't even like some of these dances these guys dance, because it's all phony. I told you, it's all phony. So it's all for money, and I know yours is genuine, and I found out, God works in mysterious ways. I found out why yours was genuine, and I know you seen that comment I left on your video. I knew it was, I'm not stupid. And my mother knows that. I know when the phoniest shit when people do it for money. And that's when my guy friend knows, when people do it for money, it's not real. You're not being your authentic self. And,
Right.
My mind is gone. I am honored, amongst all the male dancers that I was exposed to, Neo, Omarion, and, Jason Derulo. I think the happiest moment that I had dancing with a man is going to be with you. I'm so serious, and I'm going to be completely honest. All of male dancers I've danced with, I am the most happiest and honored to dance with you. And I don't think you understand that. Yeah, all a million of male dancers that I've danced with, I am, honored. And this is coming from me. The 5-year-old, the 5-year-old doing it, I'm honored, dancing with you, not even Michael Jackson's, I'm not going to play Austin Brown. I love Austin, but I don't know. It's a tie between Austin and you. I'm going to tip the scale and say you, but I'm honored. I in this lifetime I am honored, and we definitely gonna tape it. I'm probably gonna put it on VHS to show it to my kids, grandkids, my kids. Definitely, yeah, definitely. If I'm fortunate to have kids, they kids, I'm putting that shit on VHS. Just like my grandmother, she had my stuff that I did when I was younger on VHS, but my father converted it to DVD. But I want that shit on VHS, because that shit is going to be classic. Working with you is going to be classic.
Absolutely.
That's how much I'm honored, to have that in my movie collection or DVD. That shit is going to be mad. All we're going to do is do magic. All it is going to be magical. You got that shit, I got that shit. That's all it's going to be.
Mm-hmm.
So it's just going to be in alignment, man.
Absolutely.
You know what
get ready.
Yeah, you know what was funny? I I thought that when you went live, because I signed up for your live when you did James Brown, when you had your cousins come, I don't know if they're your cousins or nephews. I was like,
my nephew.
Yeah, I was like, they brought out the cape. Like, if we live in the same town, like me, I was born in Virginia. I'm born in Virginia, raised in Virginia, raised in New York, raised so many places. You're in Indianapolis, right?
Uh-huh.
Yeah, like, can you imagine if we went to school together? And I thank God that didn't happen. I was thinking this morning, if we was went to the same school or was in the same environment, we would probably be millionaires. Like, people would be sick of us. Prepare to be sick of me. They would be sick of us. Because people would go crazy. They would, like, I don't dance. My friends that grew up with me, my childhood friends, know I don't dance for money, and I never did anything for money. I dance because, you know, that's something that the creators, my ancestry, you know, that's something that the divine entities gave me, that talent, you know. And, you know, like I said, you know, the divine beings, I noticed at 5 years old when I started to dance, you know, when I was a kid, I always knew that it was something, you know, ancestral, you know. When you say ancestors, you got to think about the divine entities, the divine beings that came before us. I always knew that it was something ancestral. So, you know, I didn't never confiscate that for money. Okay, well, even when I see dance competitions, don't get me wrong, I come across them all the time, World of Dance. You know, money comes and goes, and I never wanted to trade what the divine beings gave me for money. That's not living, you know. Yeah. Okay, cool, you know, but like me, I like doing free concerts, like, you know, I book shows or whatever. I like to do it for free. And that's where I felt the most comfortable. It's never been a money. Let's do this for money thing for me. I that's so disrespectful to my ancestors, you know. You know, how my father said, you know, he raised me. As long as I got my resources, that's fine. But, you know, you got some people that's money hungry, and that's when it's not genuine. Uh-huh. But, you know, people would be sick of us. I think that we would set the town, like, the whole freaking town would be on fire. Because then people's like, are y'all going to put out another video? Are y'all going to do it? Like, people, we would have, like, a lemonade stand. I would just be, you know, probably charging people, like, we, you know. But, you know, even if we did it for money and I was raised, you know, in your area, I would want to give it back. Like, I would want to, you know, give back and not keep it for myself, you know.
Yeah.
You know, we would definitely, knowing me, if I knew you, knowing my mind and who I am as a human being, I would definitely make you give it back. I would pull you over to the side and like, yo, this is what we're doing. We're giving this back to the community, or, you know, we want to, you know, start this organization and do this. But,
yeah, you know, like a charity.
Charity.
Concert.
Oh, yeah, definitely a charity, you know, where people can get their resources that don't get access to things. Because all I'm going to do is vibe off of your energy, and you would vibe for me. And, you know, we have that deep appreciation for, you know, the greats, you know. And, you know, definitely come from an authentic space, but it's two divine beings, you know. And it would be beautiful, but, you know, I'm happy that we met each other this way. Thank you, God. Hey, I see you. Yeah, good looks. I was in my shower like, good looks, ancestors, good looks. I see you. You know, and they up there waving. Yeah. We got you. We told you we got your back. We always come through with you. We always get you the best people in your life. Like, yeah. You know, and I, you know, I guess that comes from me communicating with them and praying, you know, and meditation and just knowing, you know, and, you know, getting getting in contact with them, you know, and stuff like that. But other than that, you know, I'm glad you can astronomically see where I'm coming from, and I astronomically understand where you're coming from. Like, even when you told me what your friends told you about you are the least saying, yeah, and I said, just you are him, just get over it. Like, you understand what I meant, so. You know, I post all the oldies on my YouTube channel. I post a lot of things, but, you know, I want to, because I don't have my iPhone 13 no more, so when I get that, I can do clear videos, you know, and it's so easier for me to edit, because I got cinematography. You know, I want to do more TikTok videos, so, you know, I want to brainstorm and just come from an authentic place and try to understand what message that I want to send out to the world. I just, you know, want it to be as genuine as you. Oh, that's all I want. I got to write that in my book, you know, and... You know, I'm going to share this with you also because you're a special person to me. I found this store because I like ballroom. I like Bollywood. I would say international dancer. It's so much money that I want to invest in costumes. And I'm a ballerina, so I have my ballerina gear. I got my leotards. I got my tutu. I got my shoes, my ballerina shoes. I got all my dancing gear. Like, even from high school, I have all my gear and stuff like that. My sweatpants, jogger, and stuff like that. Like, I have my grandmother and my mom supplied me with all those supplies. Definitely my grandmother, but, you know, I want to invest more in more leotards, crystal leotards. You make me want to bring out my afros. I said, oh, I definitely got to come with the heat. I got to come with the heat, yeah. The afros, the crystal leotards. Boy, y'all don't even know what's in my shopping cart right now. I'm about to show down for TikTok. Like, I'm about to come for these dances, man. Yeah, y'all cool, but wait until you see what I got up my sleeve, cause y'all ain't gonna know what hit y'all. I'm gonna let y'all have your time. I'm gonna let y'all have your time. You know, you got your Michael Jackson, and I am clapping. I was like, damn, he did not come to play. He got the outfits, you know, and. Man, but when I seen you bring out that freaking board, I was like, what? My mouth dry. I was like, what in the world? I ain't never seen no shit like that ever.
I
was like, what side of TikTok am I on? God, I didn't want to write that under your video. What side am I on?
Yeah, I hadn't used the shoes, because like I was saying in the video, one of the shoes was in the repair shop because it ripped on me last year. I used it for an audition to be in a talent show, but that got canceled because of COVID, and they were like, hey, we're just canceling everything. And I'm just like, damn. And I'm just, because I really want, but here's the thing. So like the first prize winner was like $5,000, but I was telling my mom, I was like, it's much more, it's more than the money, mom. It's more than winning. It's just performing and dancing that's rewarding, you know? Mm-hmm. And I've been in like musical theater for the past 3 years, and like we aren't like paid, like, you know, salary employees or whatever you want to call it in that particular theater company. It's like we're like independent contractors, so we do get like compensated by selling like a specific amount of tickets. But like for me, the reward has just always just been like being on stage and just performing, you know. And oh my lord, I forgot why I brought that up. Wait, where was I going with this? Anyway, I just love performing, and
Are you verified on TikTok?
No, I'm not. I'm surprised I'm not. Actually, I'm like, wait, something ain't right. Cause like, I see other accounts where they're like, don't have like less followers than me. Or I know that doesn't really count, but I'm like, something ain't right.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm like, what do y'all do? I should be verified. It mm-hmm. seemed like I would be, but mm-hmm. I don't know.
Have you ever seek verification?
I've looked into it, but I've never really even been, like, you know, like, driven, you know, mm-hmm. by, like, you know, oh, I gotta, I need to be verified by TikTok, you know. Mm-hmm. No, but, I mean, I guess I should look back into it. Because mm-hmm. at this point, I'm like, well, you know, y'all just need to go ahead and just go ahead and put that blue check mark next to my profile and mm-hmm. call it a day. Thank you very much. But
yeah. But yeah, I'm glad I didn't get my point across, man. Hey, you leave your worries behind. 'Cause rain shine, you're mine. My father would sing that in the kitchen or in the car. You know the wheels are turning. We're keeping it hot. Grab your friends, taking you on a trip. Leave your worries behind. You know, we in 2022 and I play that going to the post office. I'm still playing Heat Wave until I leave this earth. I love all the members of Heat Wave. Maybe they put that in my casket when I pass on. I was 18, 19 years old. I said, oh, this gotta be in my casket, because this shaped me as a kid. This is my life. Like, you better throw some Earth, Wind, and Fire. All I'm asking for Earth, Wind, and Fire, some the Earth, Wind, and Fire wax. Some Heat Wave, throw that in my casket. You know, pour 40 ounce. Let me stop.
Yeah.
You know, but, you know, life is about rejoicing, you know.
Oh,
and,
for sure.
You know, your time here is limited, and I definitely would love them albums in my damn casket, because, Lord have mercy, I love Heat Wave. That's how real it is, you know.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. And I just, like, I'm gonna just, like, say this, like, and I'm gonna say it again, like, I'm like 100% hype and excited. Like whenever we do get to dance, like, let's go. I'm down. You know,
yeah.
Like, I am down.
Yeah, I never thought that we would get there. You know, I never asked for it. I only asked to physically, tell you that I love you, and meet your mom. You know, tell her she did a good job with you, but that never ever came to my mind, because, you know, you dance royalty. Like, who am I to ask you that? Like, you're so young, but you definitely been here before. And, you know, I'm just the girl that just do it for fun, you know, that, you know, trying to preserve her inner child. And I never would think to ask you, maybe we should do this, because it's so far out. You know, you know, talking to you, it's like talking to the members of Heat Wave. Like, it's a realm that I never think I would get to. You know, it's a realm of respect, and it's a realm of legendary that I don't even think that I'm worthy to ask you that. You know, for you to, you know, be reincarnated through him, you know, even me speaking to Ralph Johnson in Earth, Wind, and Fire, so surreal. And I had to tell him that, you know, you guys gave me the best childhood. And I don't want to listen to hip-hop. I don't want to listen to rap. I don't want to listen to what's on the radio. I don't want to listen to the bad things that I've been shoving down our throat. Like, you guys really changed lives. You guys really are my heroes. You guys are my blood. You guys are my air. You guys are my everything. And I was fortunate to tell Ralph Johnson that. And he's looking at me like, I didn't know that. I didn't know we are the... I don't know. I think he was coming from a humble place, and I wanted to, because he's like in his 60s. I want to say, you don't know your best poop on a freaking, that's the real in my mind. It's just like, you are the best freaking band on the freaking earth. And he was so humble. He was like, I didn't know that. And you know, I guess that was the right way to go about it. But
yeah,
I told, you know, this guy that I'm interested in, and you know, my father, you know, that was, he was at work that day I went, that was for my birthday. I got to see them VIP, and I will never forget that night ever. Like, I told the guy that I'm interested in that, you know, my mother gave birth to me. Whoop, she had a kid, but you know, I have my own struggles. I'm not always the happiest person in the world. You know, I have my, you know, disabilities or whatever that I'm, you know, open about on YouTube. But, you know, I honestly, you know, yeah, we're young, but I honestly didn't plan on living long. I didn't plan on being here this long. You know, I told the guy that I'm interested in, like, I just wanted to meet Maurice White, you know, Earth, Wind & Fire, you know, meet Pharrell and just leave. That's it. I just came. My mother just gave birth. She did her 9 months, so I could just meet two people and be like, deuces, and then be out. You know, and, you know, Maurice White is not here, but, you know, I cried when he passed because I always wanted to meet him. Yeah. And, you know, I'm fortunate to meet Ralph Johnson and Vernon Dean White and people from the group in this lifetime. That's the esoteric thing. These are legends. These are icons. This is the best, baddest band on the planet. This is the baddest band on, this is, they're badder than Michael Jackson. Michael Jackson's cool, you know, but, you know, this is, you know, if Maurice White was here, I would flock to Earth, Wind & Fire because this is my childhood. And I told Ralph Johnson that, you know, I didn't get a chance to tape it, but I had to verbally say it on YouTube so I can, you know, I'm a human being. My memory gets foggy sometimes. I don't understand what I said word for word, but I have to say it so when I get 60 or when I get 50, I can know and go back to my videos and know what I told him. You know, so my father spoke to me, you know, he's a musician also. He's like, well, you know, you got to do it. You know, you got to pick up a piano, you know, because, you know, when I get my finances in order, I'm going to do piano lessons. They are, you know, 15 minutes away from me. And my father took me there to meet the people. And I like the aura and I like the vibe of the place that he's taking me to. Yeah. I have to do it because I'm a fast learner and, you know, my health conditions as a teen, I didn't get a chance to, you know, do piano like I wanted to, like I initially set out to do when I was a teen, unfortunately. But you know how my grandmother told me? That shit don't mean nothing. You still got a chance. My grandmother taught me that, you know, every day is a new day, you know, right. So, absolutely. You know, that shit is not, it's not going to be an excuse for me. When I get my finances in order, I tell my father, I'm going to take my ass down to piano lessons. There's chords that I want to unlock. It's soothing chords that touch my soul, that I can identify with. It's a genetic thing. You know, if I hear these chords, these certain chords, and I can play that for myself, that's my therapy. That's me, you know, talking to myself. You know, communicating through sound. That's me, you know, talking to that spirit. But, you know, yeah, I've just, you know, my mother gonna have to take it for a while. I only care about two people, and I care about five other people, but, you know, I just wanted to meet two people. I told them I love them, and that's it. That's it, you know? I'm fortunate to do that. You know, my mom, that day I went to see them, I was, you know, Mother Nature came in, you know, it was raining, and I was like, she was like, get out the house, it's your birthday, get out the house, I don't want to get up, it's raining, I'm tired. She was like, no, she pushed me, you're going to get your ass up and have a good time, and she told me that, and that has been the most life-changing experience I have ever experienced in my life. And it's still surreal to this day, but it speaks volumes to me because I was dedicated. And I was dedicated to revisiting my childhood and, you know, living the music and living my childhood and to do that, I don't know if I had sneakers on heels, but I can run in heels. I don't know if I will. I don't know if I, because, you know, the way I, listen, let me tell you, the stage, it was a 30 minute walk. I don't know if I was running in heels. I don't know if I was running. I don't know if running heels or sneakers, but I ran. And when I heard their music playing, I was running to my childhood. It was like, if I can, you know, illustrate how I was running, it's like, girl, you run into that 5-year-old girl in Virginia when your grandmother used to take you for strolls in the park and have you in a stroller and you would see the trees and stuff like that. And I was running to my childhood. I was running to my childhood. You know, that was the closest I get to, you know, my youth growing up on them. And I was so happy. I was dancing with this guy. I like dancing with strangers so much because dancing is communicating. That's why I love to do it. I'm not big on talking. I've never been a big talker, you know, growing up and whatever. But, you know, I like dancing with strangers because, you know, it's communication, it's expression, it's a love for the arts, it's the love for, it's a second language, and I love it.
Absolutely, yeah.
I love it. And so, what you think gonna happen when we dance, it's the communication of spirit, and, you know, it's a rewarding feeling, and I'm utterly honored that you asked me to do that with you physically, because I never would think of asking you that. I didn't think that I was worthy of that, you know, but you're beautiful.
Well, all I can say is you better get ready because we dancing, so.
Yeah, I gotta bring my shoes and my outfits and my suitcase or whatever, and, you know, I told my mom, you know, I'm gonna be traveling, you know, when the shit calms down and stuff like that, but yeah, definitely. Maybe we eat some fried chicken. All I can envision us. You like fried chicken?
Yeah, I love fried chicken.
You gonna get some? We not gonna get no Popeyes. We gonna get that fried chicken, not no Popeyes. If we can't find a chicken spot like a hole in the wall, we gonna eat some. We gonna eat from a hole in the wall, a Big Betty fried chicken spot. We gonna eat from the most ratchetest ghetto fried chicken spot with grease and a big ass chef, and eat some biscuits with some Kool-Aid. That's what we want. I swear to God, once that shit is locked in my phone on my schedule, we gonna do it. We gonna get some Kool-Aid, some ratchet fried chicken. I don't care if I gotta get my hot plate and make it my damn self, cause I don't want no Popeyes. I want some authentic fried chicken on me, some cornbread, some peach cobbler with something, yo. I swear to God, if I eat something, yo, I grew up on Southern food. If we find, I got cornbread. I will tag you on TikTok. I got cornbread every month. My ritual since I moved to the South, because I was raised in the South, is to eat some fucking cornbread. I swear to God, if I eat cornbread and fried chicken with you, oh my, Yo, I swear to God, I know I'm gonna go to my grave happy, but I'm gonna go to my grave happier. God damn. Lord. Lord. God. I listen to my music and I eat fried chicken with my father and my mother. We ratchet. No, sorry, I don't like to use the term ratchet, but we he's a Southern biscuit. I like Publix chicken. I love fried chicken. I don't get my Chewy. My dog loves fried chicken. His owner say he loved fried chicken. I wasn't supposed to have Chewy. They texted me. I said, my father said, ask him what he liked to eat when we picked him up. They said he loved his fried chicken. This dog was supposed to be my dog.
Wow.
Yeah.
I love that.
Yeah, I love fried chicken. And, you know, maybe we get some collard greens. I want soul food from the ratchetest, dirtiest kidney stuff. I want that soul food that make you go to sleep like after eating it. We gonna have fun. You're gonna love me. You are going to love me. And I wish that No. I wish that my father, but he works so much. I might ask him to fly out with me or whatever and see how he feels. But you know, I'm always, you know, aware of people's schedule, but you know, even if he don't, I'm still going to show him our videos and stuff like that. And, you know, he'll know what I'm saying. I'm probably going to have my guy friend that travels with me, Christopher. He's been my friend since my childhood. He always, you know, flies and travels with me and stuff like that. And yeah, you know, but other than that, I'm so, was you always like this as a kid?
What, just what,
soulful? Yeah. Was this you when you was a kid, or no?
No, honestly, when I was little, I was always, real, I was always getting bullied and shit, but, I was pretty much, a quiet kid of the bunch. I loved to, run around and play and all that stuff, and, play in the dirt. Play with my toys and all that stuff. The hypeness probably didn't kick in till when I was 12, 13.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Wow. I was you at 5 years old. So. Lord have mercy. I was you at 5 years old. I'm you right now at my age. I'm gonna always be you. Listen here. Coming from me, you get your props. And I don't give it to everybody. You got my respect. And I don't give that to everybody. It's a very once in a lifetime thing. It's a very rare thing. It's a very rare thing.
Yeah, I'm humbled by that. Really, I'm not just saying that. I'm really.
You know, so
I'm humbled.
You know, so you know to have me talking for this long. You know, my subscribers. I did YouTube for fun. I didn't know I would start a family and, you know, it would be so warm and on my side. I this wasn't my plan, but, you know, my subscribers got me to open up. I'm writing a book actually about my life, so I'm writing as we speak. You know, I went to the doctor and this nurse said, you know, you have to tell your story. You have to write and, you know, I went through a lot in my life. And what I went through as a teen being bullied, it, you know, caused me trauma, and I'm being honest, and I don't like to speak, so I'm always fidgety, or I'm always thinking someone's going to hit me, and my friends, you know, they knew that I had anxiety. I never told them, but they knew something was up, so, you know, she pinpointed it out, listen, you got to let people know what you went through, and you got to let girls feel empowered, so, You know, it was an ancestral thing. You know, I spoke to her and I knew where she was coming from. And I knew that God, you know, put her in that office, and we had that understanding before I left. So, you know, I was so quick to write today. And I knew that if I didn't write this shit, that being that the Creator sent to me on the first, I knew that I would let my ancestors down, because they came through her to tell me to write what I have, you know, went through. So I knew what time that was, because she could have been, and I told my scribers, she could have been mean, she could have been, you know, about her paycheck and scold me and not know, you know, me or what I went through or whatever. She's a human being, I don't know her, she could have been anything, but, you know, she stuck out to me the most and said, listen, you have to do this. I know it's hard, but you have to write and let people know what you experienced and what you went through, so girls would feel empowered. So, you know, it's painful. You know, I'm gonna tell my therapist that I'm writing, you know, and I might cry or whatever, but I have to, you know, release and write. And the hardest thing I have to, this is the hardest thing I have to done as a human being solely. This is the hardest thing, is to write this book, because I went through a lot. And it's like opening a Band-Aid of a wound. It's like someone taking off your Band-Aid and exposing your wound to people. I'm exposing my wounds to human beings I don't even know. It's like tripping on glass. Like, it's like walking a mile on your feet, no shoes, no socks, on glass for a mile, and your feet is getting cut up by the glass. And once you get to that finish line, the doctors ask people you don't know, let me see your feet. And then you got to get up and lift your feet so other people can see it. In order to heal, they got to put that Band-Aid on, they got to examine it. But once you express yourself and you put that Band-Aid on, you heal. That's healing. So,
absolutely.
Yeah, I have, you know, professionals with me so I can write this book. And I can't write this book without them, because it's hard. And, you know, my therapist and my doctor knows that, you know, it's hard. It's so hard for me to talk. So, yeah, I'm going to tell her what I'm doing, and, you know, it's a traumatic feeling. But, you know, trauma is an entity, trauma is a being. And, you know, I know you probably seen Ivana Fix My Life. Once you, you know, deal with those entities and deal with those beings and have the proper treatment and the proper healing, you can, you know, live a healthier life. You can have a healthier auric field. You can, you know, move forward, not have blockage, and you can be well, you know, you can be well. And, you know, this ain't it, this ain't over, this is not over. And I told, you know, the nurse on the first, like, yo, I might not even do this book, I might not even be alive to finish this book, you know, because it's so painful. But, you know, she understands that, you know, it might not happen, it might happen, but there's always this other side that, you know, it might not happen. I might not want to, you know, revisit or, you know, go to that area in my life that was dark and being bullied and seeing her face and knowing that this person caused you to, you know, have a lifetime worth of therapy, you know. And, you know, I don't wish, I was just discussing that with my mother, I don't wish what I went through on nobody. And I told my therapist that, I'm my doctor, because I'm still in therapy since I was 15. You know, yeah, it hurts, but I'm here, I'm alive. Why am I alive? Because I'm in therapy. The professionals got me. And I'm not ashamed. I'm not ashamed because, you know, they broke me. And, you know, sometimes when people break you and you are broken, you fall apart. And when you fall apart, you're not yourself. And when you're not yourself, you're broken. And when you're broken, you need to be fixed. So, you know, they're fixing me. And this is what they get paid for. You know, sometimes, you know, it's surreal. I have a good relationship with my therapist. I asked her, why did you choose this job? You are taking on something that a human being, this is the most. You got doctors, you know, they, you know, do surgery and stuff like this. This is a mental thing. This is a human being life that you're responsible for. What made you want to take on this hard job? This job ain't easy, having me as your client. This is not easy. You chose this job. Why are you so prepared? Why am I even worried of having you? You know, she's a good therapist, but sometimes I ask myself, is this real? Why did God give me her? You know, I don't know who gave me her, but I'm fortunate to have her. And she don't even know. She knows how much I love her, but she don't even know that she chose a hard job, you know, to even have me speak. I didn't start speaking until I turned 25, until I got her, and I felt comfortable speaking to, you know, people. You know, I felt like, you know, a deer, when a deer is exposed to the public, you know, they're fine, they're thriving, not being seen and being in the woods. But soon as people want to talk to the deer is running, the deer is shaking, the deer is startled. That's me. I'm the deer. So she's getting me out of that space, and I'm like the deer getting up on his legs. I put that on my channel. I'm like the deer getting up, shaking, trying to get his balance, you know, and that's the only way I can depict it. But, you know, she gave me a voice, and I love her, and I'm learning how to speak and communicate again.
She is a guardian angel for you.
Yeah, my grandmother recognized that, and, you know, I don't know what spiritual belief she believes, but I had to tell her, I don't know what being made this switch and gave me you. I don't know what was said. And I told her, I don't know what was said behind closed doors. I told my doctor, I don't know who said what to who and who made this arrangement or what force gave me you guys. But you guys are everything. I know this is just a job. This is what you do to keep your lights on or go to work. This is the career path you have, but you don't understand how much I love you guys, and I love her, and I let her know that, you know, you don't understand. That one phone call, you know, I'm supposed to see her every month, but she checks on me every week on her own time, and that small little thing means a lot to me. I don't know. It's the universal thing. I'm just gonna have to chuck it up as my spirit guys getting my back again, and I'm just gonna have to recognize that. You know, I'm not even gonna do my research on who was responsible for this, because, you know, there's so many. I had one therapist who horrible, you know, and I had a doctor that was very horrible. So I reported them to their boss, but I don't know who makes the decision. I'm not, you know, I'm not the state. I'm not board of directors. I don't know who get told what and what's told behind closed doors dealing with people or whatever. But, you know, something happened where I know that God said, hey, listen, I got you. I got you right. I got you. I don't know what I experienced before. Even my therapist didn't like my doctors, or my mother told me, like, I don't like this lady. But I try to see the good in people. I was young, you know, so I made the switch, you know, and stuff like that. And, you know, that shit, I went from hell to heaven, like, literally. Even my subscribers knew, like, the shit that was going on, the sneaky shit that was going on, but, you know, around that time. But, you know, I just have been, you know, around that time speaking to my spirit guys and stuff like that, and you know, speaking to the creator and my ancestors, and, you know, I ask them to look out for me, protect me from all things that want to harm me or don't cause me good. And I pray for my mother, I pray for my family, and, you know, I pray for the world, you know.
Yeah.
You know, because, you know, you know, we didn't expect COVID to happen. We didn't expect none of these things to happen. But, you know, we are alive, we breathe it, and the Creator has kept us and, you know, arranged this. And, you know, I told this Lyft driver, I tell, you know, my subscribers, no, we ain't running shit. Because just like I found you, I found them. We not running nothing. I have people from Oklahoma see my videos, and I'm not saying that to brag, but this girl said she showed her mother her videos. She's like, I see her in myself. So, you know, we started vibing, connecting or whatever, and now we sisters. We close.
Yeah.
She's my family member now, and I love her. I got a sister. I got a baby sister. You know, I always wanted a sister that I could spoil, and I wished for this since I was a kid, since I was young, I always wanted a sister. And my mother was like, damn. I was like, you should have gave me, but I got one, and I love her. But, you know, I have to understand divine timing, and I pray, and I, you know, practice gratitude, and know, you know, my relationship with the Creator is my personal relationship. No one will have to understand that. You know, but, you know, I'm very grateful. I'm very grateful, and I'm remaining humble, and I'm practicing gratitude, and I love them, and I can't speak to them, you know, verbally, but, you know, I communicate to them, and I look up at the sky, and I tell them thank you so much. I literally pray. I pray, and I tell them thank you so much for, you know, all the good that they have gave me, and, you know, the people that I met, and, you know, the beings and entities, that the beautiful souls, and I thank them for that. You know, sometimes I don't have to talk. Sometimes I just look at the sky, and I could smile, and I tell them thank you, and they know I love them. They there. I see you.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Yeah, my father taught me that when I was younger also, but, you know, one thing I learned about the Creator, he gives, he takes, he removes, but you don't control, we ain't running nothing. That's something that my ex understand. We not running shit. Everything is controlled by the Creator. Everything is controlled by God. Whatever God you pray to, there's a higher being higher than us here, more powerful than we are, and we all are his vessels, and, you know, we live through them, you know, to those that want to seek it and you know, communicate, you know, with their divine self, as my grandmother would say. But other than that, you know, when it's my time to go, you know, I always said that, you know, even if I died the next day, I told one of my friends that, you know, I'm grateful, and I said on my YouTube channel, I'm grateful for all the things that they have done for me, and I love my ancestors, I love them so much, I love you know, my relationship I have with the Creator. Even, you know, when things aren't going my way, even when things are taking away from me, even when things, I'm losing things, you know, or, you know, things are, you know, rotating and transforming beyond my control, I have to surrender and tell, you know, my ancestors and I love them and, you know, thank you. You know, I'm going home and, you know, you gave me this gift. You know, you made me a loving person. You know, one thing, how I live my life spiritually, and I say this all the time. No matter how cruel, no matter how dark, no matter how cruel, no matter how dark this world gets, to always be nice, to always be grateful. Don't let this cold world change your being. Don't let this cold world change your heart. Don't let family members, don't let external entities change who you are as a human being. And that's something, even as I get older, I am, you know, practicing every day. No matter how dark, no matter how evil, no matter how, you know, mean-spirited people are, don't let that change who you are, and to stay golden and to have your inner child, and don't lose her. She's not dead.
Absolutely.
You know, I can't predict the future. I can't, you know, my biggest fear is me losing my inner child and her dying. And to be, you know, I know you've been here long enough. You in Indianapolis. You know you got some mean-spirited people out there. So some miserable, the most dirtiest miserable souls. I never would want to be that being. I never want to get to that point where I'm that. You know, there's things that, don't get me wrong, people do change. Don't get me wrong. You know, it's human nature, but I never want to be that being, that entity that caused me trauma. That negative entity, that negative being, I never want to be that negative force. And I'm never going to be that negative force. This is why I try to remain pure and stuff like that, and, you know, you know, it's one thing to protect your energy from them, but, you know, controlling your light is so easy to do that, you know. People are rude and nasty, don't be rude and nasty. When people are mean, don't be mean. When people are, you know, coming from a negative space, don't be negative. That's them, that's not you. That's not who you are. But I love you. I love you so much. I love you a lot. I love you. I love you. I love you so much. I don't think you understand how much I love you. You know, it's the warmest love that a human being can receive. You know, so I'm just transmitting that to you over the phone. I'm transmuting the sun, the warmth from my childhood, my inner child, my innocence. I'm showering that and sending out all that energy, all that charisma, all that good warmth, sun, fun, heat wave, all that shit. I'm sending to you because I love you so much. I could say 10 billion times on how much I love you.
Thank you so much. Thank you. I really don't know what else to really say. Just thank you, really. I mean, heck, I could say thank you 10 billion times. It just wouldn't.
You can say thank you one time, and I understand. I could say a billion times, I love you so much. I love you as a human being a million times until you get annoyed, until you fall asleep, until you go to work, until you come back home, until you eat your dinner, until you get married, until you have your family, until your grandkids have their kids, until your kids have their kids. And today, kids, I can tell you that a million times, and I want you to receive it, but I love you. But I'm going to wrap this conversation up because I know you are tired of me. I know you are. I don't even want to get off the phone with you because I am in love right now. Yes, it is. All right. Wow. This is so embarrassing.
No, seriously though. This was awesome. This was an amazing conversation.
Yes, it was. It needed to be had.
It absolutely. This phone call had to happen. I am looking forward to the future and the dancing, meeting your father and your mother and all that stuff, and I'm just everything, just everything.
Yeah.
I thank you so much for your support, your love, all of it. I said, the Gatorade, the cookies, the chicken we ain't even ate yet.
We ain't even eat yet. I'm praying. I'm going to pray. That's my subscribers asking me, yo, how you doing? I am praying that the world comes down so I can enjoy some fried chicken with this dancer. I'm gonna show them. I'm praying because I don't want to be traveling. Then we got a war going on. Then I don't know if they're gonna be bringing. We don't know. We are in uncertain times, but I'm gonna be praying so I can enjoy a nice hot chicken meal with you, fried chicken meal. I am praying. I'm praying in between time now because I want to enjoy a nice dinner with you, a nice southern ratchet 70s meal with you with grease on our shirts, grease on our fucking hands, just complete slobs. It's okay, babe, you could be a slob with me. It's all love. It is all love. Like two kids in a sandbox.
Exactly.
Yeah. It's all love. I love it. Oh my God. Oh, okay, but I'm going to wrap this up. This is surreal. I am in love again. I am in love with life. You made me in love with being here. You made me in love with breathing. You made me in love with speaking. You made me in love with being present, literally. And I don't even want to be here. I'm being completely honest.
I understand how you feel. I'm not going to lie. I get it. Like, I was even just at work. I was like, bro, what is happening right now? Why am I even?
Yeah, look at this shit. Look at this shit that's going on around us externally. Look at all this foolishness. But I think that creator made you do that TikTok so I can just want to be on earth, literally, because you make me want to be here.
I'm gonna say this one last thing, because I know you probably sleepy too, but I'm actually looking back at the different steps that led me to making that first Heatwave video, and it started with it was a lot of child. I've done so many live streams at this point, but it was a live stream I did, I want to say about a month ago, almost a month ago, and it started with my mom. It started with my mother. She was like, she reads all the comments.
Yeah, you said your mother read all the comments. I'm sorry, my phone got jammed.
Oh, okay. So she was just like reading all the different comments and like saying, people saying that I'm, you know, look like the lead singer from Heatwave.
Mm-hmm.
And basically, I was just saying where I see how these little individual steps just led me to just, you know, go ahead and make that video, because some dude was like, yo, he should like really make some Heatwave content. He like looks like the lead singer, and I'm like, let me just go ahead and just make some Heatwave videos. Cause why not?
Mm-hmm.
So I'm like, I just looking back, I just see how all this like led up to this point, you know?
Mm-hmm.
It led up to this, you know.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, you make me want to be here. And when I first seen your video, it hit me. God said to me, you know you're supposed to be here, right? You are supposed to be here because that 5-year-old girl is screaming. She's kicking and screaming, and she wants to be set free. And when I seen your video, I automatically channeled that. I said, wait a minute. She's that 5-year-old girl is pretty like, let me out! Let me out! I want to dance! You know? And like I said, it just automatically took me back to childhood. I seen that shit, I seen that shit, I was like, oh my God, we in trouble. Because this is a young man I don't know from a can of paint hole in the world. On the internet. I told my mother about you, and I felt so good that, you know, she told me, you know, she always encouraged me to dance and stuff like that. It's so difficult now because of all the medications I'm on, so many. And it slows me down, and it's a good thing, very good thing, because I could be like you, woo, without my medication, my energy is jolted, and like I told my doctor, that shit keep my soul right in my fucking body. That's all it does, you know. I have a lot of energy, so, you know, the medication that I have, it keeps me calm, collective, and it slows me down, and I can function, you know. I'm not, you know, high voltage, I'm not on 100, you know, while everybody's on 5, you know, so,
yeah,
you know, I'm not ashamed, I'm like many others, you know. There's some people that need it to be slowed down, but, you know, I understand what my problem was, you know, when I was younger, and why I had so much energy, and, you know, being up for hours, dancing for hours, nonstop, not drinking water, not hyperventilating, you know, my back, spraining my back, spraining my neck, injuring my feet so much. I know when I had my first Instagram before I deactivated it, you know, my feet would be injured so much, bruises and bloody feet. They called me bloody feet in high school, bloody feet, injured feet. And, you know, my mother said that, you know, if you keep doing this, you know, your legs are going to give out when you're old. So I have to be mindful also, because I like to dance in heels. Also, I like to dance in heels more than flats, because that's where I'm more comfortable. I have an arch in my foot, so when I'm in flats, I'm not comfortable. You know, she's in the medical field, so she tells me, you know, you can't keep doing this for long because you're going to mess up your legs. And, you know, I'm happy she told me that, because, you know, people have arthritis. People, you know, you see the old people and they're in pain and stuff, and that's probably going to be me, and it can be me. But, you know, at least she was mindful, and she told me, if you keep doing this, you know, I don't do it as hard as I used to as a teen and a kid, you know, that this is going to happen. You know, my father told me that also, you know, and you know, there's a lot of musicians that jeopardized their legs, Prince, Sheila E., that jeopardized their legs and bodies and rib cages and stuff like that. And, you know, I have to be mindful also, you know, because I'm not going to lie, I did take it too far. There's times where, you know, I would be so sore. My hamstrings would be torn. My arms would be torn. I would be so sore. I would have to have a sprain, you know, when I was younger. And my mother, you know, my father would have to massage my calves, my ankles, you know, my shoulder blades. He would have to get the knots out, you know. And I, you know, ever since I started taking my medication, I never had that problem. You know, cause I'm neutral. I'm fine. I'm my soul is in my body. You know, and I'm happy. You know, yeah. But you know, when I seen you do that live, I was like, ooh, them entities got him. Ooh, he's ultra. He's electric, and that's what we discussed in the chat. You know, and they was like, did he drink any water? Like, yo, like, we was like, yo, where is he getting, like, I got this screen, I screen recorded it. I was like, we was trying to figure out, like, it was like, do he sleep? Does he take breaks? You did not care. And then you went song to song. It felt like I was at a concert. Like, it just felt like I was at a concert that I paid a lot of, like, it just made me feel like I was a teenager. And I'm happy you did that live show. You know, I was happy to have that free ticket, and I didn't have to pay shit. Cause I bring my fried chicken. You know what I'm gonna do? So on some serious shit. Your next live, I'm gonna order me some fried chicken off of Amazon or some Publix or some Popeyes. I'm gonna find me some fried chicken, and I'm gonna sit. You know what? I'm gonna order it from Amazon. I'm gonna have some yams or Whole Foods. I'm gonna have some yams. Some fried chicken, some cornbread. I already got my cornbread in there. You know, I'm gonna order. Yo, man, I already got my box of cornbread. Yo, we lit. I'm going to watch it live and eat me some soul food and woo, have the biggest smile on my face. The biggest cheese grin. The biggest cheese grin. You are a show. You are worth it. I would pay money to see you. I you just make me feel like a little kid. You make me feel like I'm 5. You make me feel like I'm 6. You just make me feel that happy girl. You invoke that joyous girl, man. I recognize her.
I'm so happy about
this. Yeah, I recognize her. She's alive. She's alive. She's alive. She's alive. And, yeah. You know what? I don't know if I wrote this on your TikTok or whatever. You are entertaining in a good way. Usually I watch people's stuff. Don't get me wrong, but I get so bored. But when I watch you, I'm glued. I'm genuinely glued. Like, I don't want to leave. Like, I taped your, do you understand? I taped an hour of your stuff.
Wow,
I taped it out. Yes, I screen record out. Yo, I swear to God, I don't even like watching TV. I don't. Like, I got ADHD, low-key got ADHD. Like, it takes a lot for me to focus on something. Like, in order for me to be focused for an hour fixed, it has to be genuine. Like, I genuinely have to care. And even if I don't watch dance tutorials or whatever, you know, I love the youth, you know, I love those, yeah. I love the youth and those who came before us, but you in particular, it's like my grandmother used to have us and my father used to have me, and we would have our picnics and we would listen to soul food, and it would be the summertime. I used to have my ball that used to bounce really high. I had a good, very fortunate to have a beautiful childhood. And on my YouTube channel, I actually found time
to physically tell my grandmother thank you for all that she has done for me and given me the best childhood. You know, she didn't have a lot, but it was a lot to me to have the childhood that I had. And like I told my therapist, I wish my childhood on every human being on this fucking planet, because if they had my childhood, there wouldn't be no killing. It would be world peace. I think people need my childhood, because it would be, the world would be a better place. Literally, I had a really good childhood. So you take me back to, you know, being in Virginia and going to picnics and stuff like that, and you know, you take me back to time where I was the happiest on my time on earth, the purest, and you know, you invoke that girl in me that was happy before the trauma, before the world got to her, before she knew what demonic forces was, and you know, she wasn't protected. You take me back to the girl before, you know, they got to me. She's on the other side. Yeah, she's on the other side. I'm on this side. You know, I'm trying to get back on the other side, but I'm not there yet. But, you know, it's not your job to, but she's still there. I guess she's a ghost. You know, she watches your videos, that five-year-old girl, she's a ghost. And she's clapping, and she's cheerful, and she's happy, and she's spinning around with her fried chicken. My mother raised me on fried chicken. My mother knew I want fried chicken, one broccoli stem, and my macaroni, and I would sit at my table happy. And even though I'm a mature woman, and I'm still growing as a human being, as a woman, you know, that five-year-old girl is in the spirit realm, and she's dancing, and she's happy, and when she sees you, she's the happiest.
Absolutely. Let me say this. I feel like this makes so much like more sense now. Like I'm supposed to help you. You know, like that. Just adding everything up, like it just takes us back to that conversation. You know, we were supposed to cross paths, each other's paths, for a reason. And I'm just like, I feel very honored and like humbled that I know you, that I met you, and that I'm was able to help you. You know.
You know what I told you when I first, if you scroll back to our first messages, I said you invoked my childhood. And that five-year-old girl, and I don't know you, and you don't know me, some stranger on the internet. But, you know, my father understands where I'm coming from, and you spiritually understand where I'm coming from. And, I forgot what I was about to say, but other than that, Chaka Khan, I was able to meet her, and I told her I loved her. My mother said, "Wear your red hair, wear your red wig," and I was like, okay. At first I didn't want to, because I thought that shit would be corny. You know, I just finished up a barbecue that day. I'm a summer girl. Like, when I have my summer, me and my friends, we know we have our plans, like bags packed, never home. So I told her I loved her, and security actually put me front and center to see her that summer 2015. And she said, "I love your hair," and I grabbed her by the hands and I said, "I love you." She don't understand how much I love her. I love Shaka. That's my childhood. I don't think no human being understand how much I love Chaka Khan. I love her so much. She is magical. She's esoterical. She don't understand. I don't think she could understand. And even if I told her she wouldn't understand because she don't under, she don't know my childhood. She wasn't there when I was a kid. She don't understand mentally why I love her. It's a mental thing. You know, she can accept it, accept her roses or whatever, but she plays a significant role in my life because I grew up on her. I grew up on Live In Me. I used to dance to Live In Me. You know, I was fortunate to be exposed to her as a child. Yeah, you know, everybody that you listen to, I met, you know, even in the ones that passed on. You know, my father said that they hire new people to fill in the place or they have reunions and stuff like that. But, you know, I was sneaking out the house to see the intruders. I was sneaking out the house to see the whispers. I was sneaking out the house, like, literally 17 years old, telling my father, this is where we're going to go. I had my map. This is where we're going to go, like, Dora the Explorer. And he's like, okay, mind you, my little ass is 17, you know, seeing their tour buses and waiting in the parking lot to be that young. my mother be like, my friends be like, especially my mother, you listen to them old people. She be like, them old people. You chasing those old people. My father be like, shut up. Shut up. And I'm 17 years old and I'm sneaking out the house. Like, this is 11 o'clock, 12 o'clock in the morning. And my grandmother's calling me. Where's your daughter at? And he's covering for me. She's out seeing the whispers. Like, leave her alone. Like, you know, God damn, man. Like, damn. You know, she was always like that when I was a kid, like always worried about me. Like, damn, I'm alive, I'ma come home. Like, I'm enjoying myself. Like, damn. Damn. I know, but my father would go with me to see the concerts also. And he would be so tired. I feel so bad. I honestly do. I honestly feel bad because I'm VIP. I'm in the back taking photos. I'm young. Like, I'm not even 19 yet. I'm 18. I'm 17 doing this. And he's just following me. And, you know, he knows the songs, but, you know, I'm on his time. I'm bringing him out his time or whatever he have. I don't know what he's doing in his life. I'm saying, yo, come with me, you know, and I hate doing that. I hate taking people off their schedule. Like, I'm so sensitive about that, but, you know, he understands that I love them and how much I love them. And like I said, he talks to some of the members, and stuff like that. And, you know, even seeing the times and all the people that, you know, you listen to and you love, and I love them a million, a million, a million, a million, a million, a million, a million. I love them so much. I love them and I give them love. I give them things. And like I said, I don't like to communicate, but just know if they only knew. I even told their mothers I love them. You know, I even got the mamas. I got the mamas. I will find your mother. Like, I will find your mother. I'm going to find your mother and tell her that, you know, I love her and I love you. And it has to be said, you know.
You will be speaking with her very, very soon, actually. Now that you mentioned that.
Yeah, I even found the mothers. Amel's mother, Brandy's mother, who else mother? So many mothers I met. Omarion's mother.
That's so cool though.
Yeah, I don't know how I find the moms, and this is not intentionally. I don't go searching for people's mothers. They just show up. Rasan mother, Neil's mother, Brandy's mother. So many people mother, I had a chance to talk to and tell them how much they did a good job with them and had an impact on my life. There's one other mother I want to meet that I'm going definitely before I die or before she, God forbid, pass on. I got to meet her. I'm not going to tell you who mother I'm, but if you have a good idea, if you look on my YouTube channel, but they, kids mean a lot to me, you know, I think I love they kids more than they love them. Honestly, I love them. Some people wives I met and they wives love me, you know, and it's just for the love of music, you know. I'm respectful of all families, but you know, I'm a loving person and you know, I can only give love and show love and be loving, you know. My mother and you know, my colleagues were my, I think I went to celebrate my birthday and one of my colleagues met my mother. I invited them all out to dinner and she was like, how is she so loving? And I had a good childhood. You know, like I told you, no matter how dark this planet gets, I always want to be a light. I always want to be loving, you know, because that's a disservice to myself. I'm not hateful. I'm not vengeful, you know, and that's not me. No matter how, I don't have the heart to do, and my therapist knows that I don't have the heart to do what people've done to me. I'm not that being. We're two different entities, and she knows that we're two different beings. Even my friends see that. I don't have the heart to do that, because that's not me, and I understand that this is who I was as a kid, that I am now as a woman. But yeah, you know, it's all love, and you know, this world needs more love. And you know, unfortunately some people are not receptive of that, and that's not my problem. You know, beings are going to be beings, humans are going to be humans, and
that's true.
I defended you in a comment section. Fuck your haters, fuck them, don't listen to them, because I love you and that's all that matters. I love you and that's all that matters. They don't matter.
You're right. They don't.
And they're nobodies.
Yes, I agree.
But it is going on 1 a.m. and your cookies should be here today or Friday. And I want you to enjoy it and tell me how it tastes. I got some brownies that were sent to me, and I think I'm gonna give it to my mother and father, or you know, if I'm in out in public, give it to someone, because it's a sugar rush. It is a sugar rush. Yeah, it's a big sugar rush. For me, it's gourmet. It's made in a it's made in a restaurant. This is not prepackaged and made in a lab. This is actually a bakery, so you know, I was expecting this. And the cheesecake, I got some cheesecake for them. It was really rich, so you know, it's not better than Julia's cheesecake, but it's good for what it's good for. Brownies are sugar shock waiting to happen.
I like brownies. I like cheesecake too.
Yeah, they have cheesecake. I told you, go in David's Bakery and pick out anything you wanted.
Yeah. Don't get me wrong, I'll be loving all the other stuff. I've just always been like a cookie fanatic. I'm like cookie. I'm like the black version of Cookie Monster, honestly. So
yeah.
So, but I know I'm definitely looking forward to the cookies. I'll keep a lookout for them. Most likely though, because like the Gatorade got here like before I went to work.
Oh yeah, sometimes Amazon be like Friday and then it be there Thursday morning, so I don't trust Amazon because they usually ship fast.
Yeah, so I can't wait for them. I'm gonna have my milk, and I'm gonna have
You know what? Now that I think about it, I really should have got some cookies. I'm gonna get me some cookies this week from now, cause I'm a cookie girl. I'm not supposed to be eating chocolate, but they got some blondies in there. I was just being funny. I like the brownies they got, but I'm a cookie girl, and I should have got my ass some cookies. Like, I love cookies.
Yeah,
I'm gonna give me some cookies just because I'm gonna throw out. I don't know if somebody better take these brownies. I'm gonna give me some cookies.
Absolutely, you better get you some cookies.
I'm gonna give me some cookies because it's the way of life, man. But I'm gonna wrap this up. You have been nothing but a blessing, sweet, divine, and all the good things of the world manifested in one human body. I couldn't say it no other way. I want to keep you. I want to tie you up. I didn't even want to tell you that part. I wanted to write that but you probably don't block me on TikTok. I want to just tie you up and keep you and just say, I love you, 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 and poke you with a stick. I love you so much.
I love you too, and I appreciate you.
All right, but we're going to wrap this up because it's going on 2 hours.
I gotta get some sleep. So.
All right. It was wonderful speaking to you.
All right, dude. Wonderful speaking to you too.
All right, bye-bye.